Welcome to another installment of Postman's Daily Delivery. This is going to be a very good one. This is a special request video I got in the comments. Also, if you got any questions, leave your comments, man. I'll do a video on it, answer it in the next video or one of the next videos or whatever. So definitely leave your questions, and I'll answer them for you on the next, or one of the next ones, obviously, if I get to it, videos. So this is a pretty good question from a YouTube commenter. He said, you know, why is it so hard to sell real hip-hop beats? Like, I sensed a sense of frustration in his comment. You know, he's like, why is it so hard to sell real hip-hop beats or real good music, and all this, like, Fetty Wap type shit is selling, and that's easy to sell and whatnot. So that's basically just of his question was, like, why is it easier to sell, you know, Fetty Wap and all that type of, you know, shit mainstream that's out there? And why is it more difficult to sell, you know, if you make real hip-hop, quote-unquote, whatever that is, or different styles and genres of beats? And so that's a good question. And I've answered this 100 million times over the course of Live Off Beats. But we're going to answer it again for the new people. Some of your old people already know. You're like, okay, goddamn, how many times are you going to ask this? Now, here's the reality of the situation. The reality of it is this. Whatever's hot mainstream, the market is going to want that. I mean, that's just common sense. I mean, it's the biggest type of sound right now in the music game or the hip-hop game. A lot of new artists are going to gravitate to that. That's been happening since the beginning of the goddamn music. So if that's what's hot, everybody's bubbling. I remember back in the day when I was online, first getting online, it was the Lil Jon sound. Everybody wanted to buy them Lil Jon knockoff beats, and we were selling those. You know what I'm saying? That was the thing. And so then I watched it turn into the trap. It turned into, you know, Drake-type beats, and then it turned into, you know, what it is now. You know, the trap still has a strong hold on it because that's what's the biggest music out there. And so artists want to make songs that are relevant to today, so they look for that sound that's out there. That's why you're going to sell a lot of that, or it's easier to find customers for that type of sound. That's just the way it is. That's in any marketplace in the world. So you as a producer, let's say you don't make that type of music. Well, I don't really enjoy making that type of music. Well, you have to understand that there's also other markets available to you. You understand? But they're not mainstream. So what that means is, you know, if you make, let's say, real hip-hop, quote-unquote, I'm assuming he means, like, you know, stuff that you know, hopefully he's not talking about outdated music. Usually people say real hip-hop, they mean, well, why don't some shit designed from 1995? Nobody wants that crap, okay? It was good then, but it's not relevant. But they're also, you know, more musical, you know, type of stuff. That's what he's talking about. You know, you can find those customers. There's a lot of artists out there. They're not mainstream, but they're looking for those type of beats, and you have to find them and market that way. Now, I know you don't have you're probably not a customer because of branding of big bucks, branding for big bucks. We talk about this. You got to know your customer. So if you're making that type of music, then you got to know who your customer is and where they're at. I remember we used to sell West Coast beats, a lot of West Coast beats. And West Coast wasn't popular, ain't been mainstream for 20 years. But there's a lot of artists who still love that sound, and they want to keep making that sound. They have fans who like that sound. Though it's not mainstream, it's more or less underground, but they buy beats. But my job is to say, okay, this is for you. And it's what we call a niche. That's called niching. So now you got your own little niche. And I remember I did an interview, maybe about 5 years ago now, and he was one of the top sellers on SoundClick. And what was amazing to me about DJ Corbett was his name, but Black Light LLC was the name of the music production business he had. And one of the things that was interesting is that his style of music was really good, soulful, you know, musical, piano type music. You know, it really wasn't mainstream. I wouldn't have heard it on a, you know, not most of his beats you wouldn't even probably hear on the radio, but he was selling like hotcakes. And when we interviewed him, the interesting thing was is just that, you know, he knew who he was and who his customer was, who his customer base was, and who he was trying to target. And that's the whole thing about it, man. You have to know what type of music you're making and who's your artist base. And now you have to make your marketing and advertising geared towards them. Now, the guy who asked the question, I'm pretty sure you probably aren't advertising. You haven't figured out your customer avatar and all that type of stuff, because really, it's easier to sell the niche type beats like R&B or West Coast or underground that's not popular, simply because a lot of times there's not a lot of producers making those type of beats and trying to sell them. So if you can become the brand for that type of beats, you're going to get all those artists that are looking for that type of music. They're going to go to you because you have a brand that's for them. So we talked about that in Branding for Big Bucks, where it's about, hey, I'm showing you how to instead of just thinking about selling a bunch of different beats, you say, okay, I'm going to make my music production company niche towards a specific demographic of artists. So I want the artists who are looking for real hip hop, you know, maybe looking for Knife Wonder type beats, or maybe you're thinking about, who else would I consider like that? You know, Knife Wonder or, wow, it's been so long, maybe old Kanye type stuff, or, you know, stuff like that, you know, who's a little bit more, you know, more soulful, more musical and whatnot, not really the trap shit that's out now with the Fetty Waps and all that stuff. So usually you can corner that market pretty easily and get really loyal customers because they can't find that sound anywhere else. You see what I'm saying? So it's really a matter of understanding your customer base and creating your brand around attracting that customer base. And we talked about that for Branding for Big Bucks. See, I'm not, when you get the courses, see, we're talking big, high-level courses that I'm selling to you for practically nothing. So I'm going to raise those prices because the game I'm giving you, what I'm telling you to do right now is what makes you successful and what's going to make your business, music production business, go to the next level. Because simply put, this is the stuff nobody knows. You understand? But this is what the big dogs know, and I'm telling you how to do it. It's real simple. Create a customer avatar. That means that you know exactly who your customer is in terms of what artists, what type of music do they like, why do they like it, what do they make, and then you build your whole brand around that particular base. So that's how you do that. Now, in terms of it, the mainstream stuff is always going to be what's hot at the time. A lot of artists are going to flock to that. That's just, we know that already. That's been happening forever. Whatever the hot sound is, everybody wants to mimic that. So if it's DJ Mustard, a lot of people want DJ Mustard type beats. And we talked about this before. You can have two different beat sites. You can have one beat site that caters to the mainstream and one beat site that caters to your love of music, a different niche. You don't have to have just one beat site. You can niche your each beat site, and that way you're getting two different demographics because that stuff may sell fast and you make it find those customers easier. You see what I'm saying? Now, I'm talking like this. It sounds more business speak because this is a music production business, so you gotta treat it like one. If you wanna hustle beats, you're at the wrong place. You're not gonna live off beats that way. So you have to understand your demographics. So is it easier to sell the mainstream stuff? I think it's easier to find those customers because they're everywhere because that's what's hot. But I also think they're not as loyal, so they won't stay with you as long. You know, one of the things about DJ Corbett, what he was saying is how long his customers stay with him. Because you can't find that music everywhere. So they become really loyal to your brand. Whereas if you make what's hot, the beat of the month, you know, what's hot this month, then they can go find that 100 different other beat sites. So they're not going to be necessarily too loyal to your brand. So I would say it's harder to find those customers, but it's easier to keep selling to those customers. Whereas if it's easier to find, you know, the hot trap sound or whatever sound of the month is, you can find those customers everywhere. But it's harder to keep reselling them and keep those customers and keep them loyal to your brand because they can find that anywhere. Maybe somebody doing it better than you are. You understand what I'm saying? So, you know, my thing is, my philosophy, when I was young and I first started it, you know, in the game, I just was making what was hot at the time because that's what was selling. It was, you know, then I learned about branding and that type of stuff, and we started to switch it up. And now I'm for do whatever you feel. You know what I'm saying? But you can also have multiple beat sites and, you know, do whatever you love. Make sure you express that. If you're making, you know, pop music or country music, whatever it is, have your country music beat site. Make sure there's a market there. But then you can, if you want to just hustle up some money, you know what I'm saying? Hey, man, be a conglomerate. You can also create a beat site that caters to what's hot right now. You know, those are fun to make too. You know what I mean? Like, as a producer, I always feel like you should have fun giving your take on what's hot right now as well. You know, just trying to stay, keep your sound on some old ass sound from 1993. I mean, that's, to me, you're not a good producer. Because a good producer is supposed to be able to take what's going on in the world today and put it into the music. And the world is not like it was in 1995, so it's not being put in your music. You know, you're supposed to be taking different elements, always updating and upgrading your sound. That's why the great producers aren't still relevant to this day. Timbaland came out when, you know, in 1994, he was 95. You understand what I'm saying? And now he's still relevant 20 years later. Same thing with Pharrell. You know, that first record came out in, what, 1992, 93? That's 23 years ago. Still relevant, making hit records to today. But the sound doesn't sound the same as it did back then. You know, you got to continue to update and upgrade your sound, you know? So, anyways, if you don't have Branding for Big Bucks, it's an audio course where I lay out step-by-step how to get your brand right. A lot of you are just putting your beat sites up, and you're not thinking about your brand and how you're going to, you know, last 5-10 years down the road, man. You know, if you're going to live off this thing, not for 5 minutes. You know, how to keep customers, how to build your customer avatar, so that way you know exactly who your customer is, what to say to get them. You know who your brand is, what your brand is, what fits your brand, the type of music you sell. And that makes it easier for you to sell and easier for you to keep your customers. And also easier for you to find customers because they know exactly what they're there to buy, instead of just being random and all over the place. So you got to get Branding for Big Bucks. Download the audio course. I'm raising the prices on everything because I've been giving you this information for way too cheap for far too long. So you can get it right now. Possibly the price is not raised depending on when you watch the video. But I'll catch you later. Just click down there. Let's get to it. Peace.